Hi guys, and welcome to this exciting tutorial with me, Donna. In this tutorial, we're gonna be using Archicad 21, as I said before. This is the brand new Archicad 21 with the new features like rail tool and the stairs. Okay, we're gonna be seeing that afterward. All right, so we're gonna start Archicad. When you're first working on Archicad, the first thing to do is you're gonna specify your working units to do so. So we go to Option, Project Preference, and Working Units. And here you're gonna specify your working units. I'm used to work on centimeters, on a metric. And okay, so for the tutorial, we're gonna set it to centimeter, but later you can use inches or I don't know. Okay, depending on how you are used to. So I hit okay. And then going back here again and dimension. With the dimension, I'll use plain meters, but I'm just gonna set the decimal to 2. All right. Okay, so now hit OK. Then the next thing to do is we're gonna set the story height. Right click here, story settings, and set this to 3 meters. Yeah, in default it's 3 meters, but just check. Sometimes it's 2.80. All right. Okay, then when you're working on Archicad 21, this menu here used to disappear when you click here, like that. So you always have to click here, not like before. It's hanging here. Okay, so we can hang it there. We go to Window, then okay, palettes, and you hit this here, navigator, yeah, to get it stuck there. All right, so now we're gonna be working on worksheets. What is worksheets? Worksheets is the plan, the 2D plan that you've drawn from AutoCAD or from a 2D editing software, and you're gonna import in Archicad so that will make your drawing easier and quicker. Yeah, you can also work from a PDF or image, JPEG, or anything. So for that you just need to set up the worksheets. So I'm going to right click here, new worksheets. I'm gonna name it 01, then the ground floor, create. There you are. So now you need to use the worksheet tool, the drawing tool here. You click inside and then you open the folder you just downloaded for the project DWG file. All right, so these are the files you can import here. You can import DXF or DWG or JPEG, GIF, etc. There are a lot of supported formats. All right, so you're gonna take, gonna choose this RDC DWG, then open. Okay, so here, make sure when you're working on millimeters, this is in millimeters or inches. Okay. All right, place. Okay, so it depends on the what you were using when you were drawing this here. Since I was using centimeters, so I'm going to use millimeters when I import it here. Okay, now, when your drawing is imported, what you're gonna do next is you check the dimension. Okay, so we're gonna take this here, measure, or you just hit the shortcut M, then you measure this. Okay, this is 24. For instance, when this this here was not 24, let's say it was okay, let me bring this down. Wait, for instance, this, no. Yep. like this. Okay, this is just for showing you an example. Like this, when you've imported your drawing, and you hit M, then you measure this here, and for example, here I find 16. Okay, so it's not the right scale. For example, my doors, is like, how many? 54 centimeter. That's too small. I mean that when you've imported your drawing, it's not at the right scale, at the right measure. So now you need to rescale it. So you select it and you take this here, resize, or Control K. Okay. Then make sure this is checked, define graphically. This means we're going to define our scale graphically and hit OK. And now take this to here, okay? And now enter the right size of this part. Like this one should be 24. I hit 24 and hit enter. Now check it, hit M for measure. Now we have 24, and I'm gonna check my door, the door here, at the right size, 80. Okay, so that's how to import and then resize things in a worksheets or a plan you've imported from AutoCAD or from somewhere. Alright, so the next thing to do is we're gonna go to here, you go to ground floor here, you double click to open it, and now we have this. To fit it in window, you just click this here, fit in window, so as to get it centered, in your window. And now, next thing to do is we're gonna set up our walls. So you click on the walls here. We're gonna use the simple wall. Enter the size. This is 24. And then go to model and check those here. We're gonna use the same same color for the inside and outside of our wall. So you click this here to match all the textures, and we're gonna search for a stucco white fine this here, then hit OK. All right, so now where should we start? I have this frame, you see, those frames here, these are for the facade views. Then we're gonna be working inside. Don't worry that, don't worry, your wall, your building is not going over here, because these are a very large distance between those. Okay, we're gonna draw inside. Okay, so now we're going to follow our worksheets. So where should I see it? Then we have this option here. The shortcut is Alt F2. Okay, so you activate this here, and then now you need to open it, open the reference. Now we have the reference right here, and then we're gonna choose this here, browse from trace reference. All right, so now this is a clone of this window right here. All right, so I'm going to check to search this here, this worksheets. So I got it here and I hit OK. Now I have it a little bit down here. I'm gonna bring it inside of here. So we got this drag reference here. So you hit this and I'm gonna center it inside of our frames here. Okay, so now we have the trace and reference, and we can change the colors. For example, if you want it red, and or if you want it any colors you want, you can customize, choose other color, and you can search for your favorite color For example, let's choose blue. All right, like this, blue. All right, so, okay, so this is the reference, okay? This is reference, and this here is the active. What is active? Active means if I'm drawing the wall like this, where's my wall? Yeah, there you are. Okay, if I'm drawing my wall, okay, this is just for showing you what I'm talking about. All right, so the active is this here. So, for example, I can decrease the opacity of this here. I can decrease like that. And I can even change the color if I want it red and decrease. This is just for the opacity, and this is our reference, okay? You can decrease the opacity like that. All right, so that's it. So when you activate the original color, it's gonna set it to the original color. Okay, so now you know how to use this here. This is for rotating. This is the reset to default position, because you know the default position was down here and we've dragged it into the center of this here. But if I want it back, so you click here. Now, rebuild reference. You know, sometimes when you've closed this project, and you open it back to continue your work, and sometimes you don't see your reference. It's not refreshed, it means. So you need to refresh your reference so that you can work on it again. So you click this here, rebuild. Yep, that's it. And we have this here. What is it? Yeah, show height splitter. So when you activate that, and you got this here, okay? So this is for showing, for comparing your reference to your project. Okay, let's see it. For example, this. And if you want to see what the reference and what is the project on it, like that, to compare, to see what is beneath it, to see your reference. Okay, so that's it. And this here, make fill zone transparent when you've done a fill zone or anything. Okay, this is for drag. This here is reference on top. So you can click this and you get the reference on top and your project is at the bottom. All right, so yeah, so I click it again to put my project on it. All right, so that's it for this part, and we're gonna meet on the next part. We're gonna start drawing our walls. Okay, this is just for showing you how to create a worksheet, how to work with the reference. All right, so see you on the next part.